ओके सो अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन एट स्कूल. अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन हु इज वेरी वेरी फेमस अमंग ऑल साइंटिस्ट, ऑल स्टूडेंट, स्पेशली द वंस हु आर इन साइंस और इन मेडिकल नॉन मेडिकल, दे ऑल नो अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन वेरी वेरी वेल. ओके, अ ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट, अ ग्रेट फिजिस्ट. सो द वन, द साइंटिस्ट, द वन हु इज, यू नो, द वन हु गेव द वर्ल्ड द बिगेस्ट थियोरीज विदाउट विच द साइंस might not have been what it is today. So it's very, very important to know like what that person was when he was a student. What made Albert Einstein become Albert Einstein, the great Albert Einstein? So what he was when he was a student, what kind of student he was, how was he different than what we are now? Or are we like Albert Einstein or not? Let's see. Okay, what's the first quality of a scientist? Tell. Okay, so Asis says like the first quality of. Okay. Harnoor, right? Harnoor says that the first quality of a scientist is that this person should be curious. Curiosity should be there. You should know. You want to know like why some, what is curiosity then? What is curiosity? To know more. You want to know more and more. And how do you know something more? Okay, you want to know more by saying why. So curiosity is knowing why. Curiosity is knowing why. That is why, when you want to know something why, it means that you want to widen your horizon. You want to think. You want others to think. Okay, because when you just keep on thinking about what, when, where, that is something factual. Okay, when you say where is it? It is at some particular place. When it has some particular date, it's not about curiosity. Curiosity is like, why did it happen? Okay, how can it be stopped? When, why, or how? They make you think more and more. So the person who is a scientist or the person who has got a scientific temperament is the one who is curious, the one who is inquisitive to know more and more. What else do you think is the quality of a scientist? Okay, one should be inquisitive, curious. Okay, focused. According to you, the person who is focused, so the scientists are focused. Okay, so, and even Albert Einstein was very focused. So focused that he would never ever remember the minutest things of his life. He was a biggest forgetful person, you know. He would not remember anything. He would even forget his own name. He would even forget like where he's going. Once he was going somewhere by train, the ticket checker came and asked him like, "Sir, your ticket?" So he didn't have the ticket. He had the ticket, but he didn't know where he kept it. Then he was asked, "Okay, sir," because he was a famous person. He had got Nobel Award by that time. So the ticket checker said, "Okay, sir, you just tell me where are you going. I can give you the ticket right now." He didn't even remember where his ticket was. Where was he going? So he was a forgetful person up to that extent. So when do you forget? It's not that when you are careless. You forget when you are focused upon something. Okay? When you just want to do something, when you've got one mission. So that's how that person was able to give the word, the Einstein's theory. Okay, and that theory has not been yet challenged by anyone so far. So, okay, focus. Okay. When you are focused, you might forget to take your dinner also. You might forget to talk to your friend. You might forget to wish your friend happy birthday. You might forget to reach a party. Okay, you might forget to, yeah. You might forget to sleep. You might forget to turn on your mobile, or you might forget to update your status. But when you are very particular about updating your status, you're very particular about wishing your friends happy birthday, you're very particular about sending the gift to your friend, it means that you are not very focused with your mission.
And that means you are focused in society.
Yes, it means your focus is somewhere else. You are very social. Okay, so it's not about being wrong or right. It's not about that. But for the time being, you should know what your mission is. These things, social setup can be done in the later on also. But there is a particular time for everything. This time which you are right now, this time will never come back in your life. But what you are opting right now, though for that the whole life is there. So forget other things. That is why we are going to read about Albert Einstein. We were talking about like what Albert Einstein, what kind of person he was. But before that, we are going to discuss generally like what kind of person is usually a scientist or a great person. Okay, focused, curious, inquisitive. What else? Creative. Okay. Yes, creative. Who is a creative person? Whom do we call a creative person? Creative person is a one who can create, who has his own thought, who is original by ideas, whose ideas are original. That is a creative person. And creative person need, it's not that only scientists are creative. The poets are creative. The writers are creative. The actors are creative. Okay, the painters are creative. Okay, anyone who does something new is creative. Anyone. Anyone who gives a new edge to something old, he's creative. Okay, when you are able to give something your own signature, you are creative. Okay, so creativity is just not about being a scientist, but it is having a scientific bent of mind. Even a painter may have a scientific bent of mind. Even a musician may have a scientific bent of mind. Okay, each time we listen a new song, there is a new composition, new tune, new music. It's all being creative. Otherwise, the music ragas are all same, sa re ga ma. And from there, each time the new versions come up. That is being creative. And all people have got the same colors in palette, but all artists are able to give the new version of art. That is being creative. So we were talking about like what's a person who has got a scientific bent of mind? He's creative also. He's got original ideas, doesn't copy anyone. Okay, so and the creative, original, innovative, okay, focused, curious, inquisitive. What else? Yeah. He has a faith in himself. That's why he's able to say that. That's why he's creative. When you don't have confidence in you, when you are not confident about yourself, then how can you be creative? Creative people are always confident. Confidence means having faith in yourself. Okay, believing in yourself is being optimist. It is being confident. Okay, when we say better have confidence, it means that believe in yourself. So confidence is another quality of scientists. They know like what they are doing that is going to be right. They are confident. Okay. What next? Who else are the people who are scientists? Okay, confidence, belief. Okay, optimism ho gaya. Theek hai? Optimists, they never give up. They go on and on and on. The scientists never do, they are never able to come out with one, fact at once. Okay, they might have to spend sleepless nights for years, maybe the whole life they spent. And they are always thinking about one thing. Okay, we were talking about like they are focused. So because of all these things, they are focused because they know like they have to. They sleep that idea, they drink that idea, they eat that idea, they sleep that idea, they bathe that idea. There was a scientist, the one who ran naked while taking bath. Eureka! Have you heard of that story? Yes. He was, when he was taking bath, he got to the idea, like what he had been working upon that idea for years. And all of a sudden, the moment he realized that, oh my God, it is this, he ran out. Eureka means found. I found the answer. I found the answer. So that is focus. When you keep on thinking about one thing always, when you're thinking about one thing always, of course, you will forget other things. Okay, that focus is required to be what these people were. Okay, so the biggest quality of a scientist is question. Question. Why, and why? So that we discussed in the beginning also, but there we were talking it from the point of view of being inquisitive or curious. But sometimes when the established norms are there, you say, why? Why will I accept it as it is? Okay, when the things are going on in order, the things are all fine, but a creative person always asks, like, why? He tries to establish the fact with proof. So that's the biggest quality of a scientist. So let's see, like, how, why, what kind of person Albert Einstein was at school. So Albert Einstein, you know, he questioned existing norms. He questioned existing norms. Because we all know Albert Einstein as a scientist. But for your kind information, let me tell you that he was the one who loved music, language, geography, history, and he was a great, he used to play mouth organ very well, violin. There is an instrument he is very fond of. Basically, he loved all. He loved to do, explore all subjects. Otherwise, children usually say, ma'am, I don't like this subject. I don't like to do this. But basically, when you are a scientist, then for you, knowledge is everything. A scientist, you know, reads everything. Okay, Abdul Kalam, the one who is known to be the missile man of India, great scientist of India, the one who gave new name, new height to the scientific standards of India. He was a great writer also. He was a great writer. You cannot write when you are not fond of, you know, literature, language. Wings of Fire, read his autobiography. So we were talking about, like, this man, you know, Albert Einstein, he questioned existing norms. I'll come to this a bit later, but see, he loved so many things. Geography. And yes, the biggest thing is he loved to read all these things, the things which were not even prescribed in his syllabus. Okay, then what he hated cramming, he hated rote learning. What did he hate? He hated rote learning, cramming, he hated noise. He hated quarrels or fights or disputes. What he loved, he loved peace. Okay, he loved peace. At the same time, he hated noise or quarrels or disputes or arguments. He hated rote learning, cramming. Right? I've already told you that he questioned the existing norms. I've already told you that he loved history, geography, everything. Then you have to assess, like, was he a good student? You'll have to see, like, was he a good student? Let me tell you a small incident from his life. In the very beginning, we'll read that he will have a little tussle with his history teacher. He will have an argument with a history teacher. What will happen that the history teacher will ask him a question on, like, when did some war take place? What will be the question asked to him? When did the war take place? He will simply say, no, sir, or no, ma'am, I don't know the answer. Then he's asked, like, why don't you know the answer? And his answer is, because I don't see any point in learning the date. Why didn't he know the answer? Because he did not, because he thought like, why should I learn when? So teacher asked him like, so do we have to ask you? Like, what is Albert Einstein's theory of education? At the time, the teacher was actually making fun of Einstein, but that time teacher did not know that Albert Einstein's, what Albert Einstein was actually saying, that will actually become Albert Einstein's theory of education. What is theory of education? That is think. There is nothing in learning facts. Something which make you go beyond facts is education. It's not important to learn when did some war take place. More important is like, why did war take place? Because when you'll see like, why did war take place? Then of course you learn how to stop it in the future also. So that the humanity comes to know like how to stop a war in the future. So Albert Einstein had an argument with a history teacher then. From this incident, you people tell me, is it true that Albert Einstein did not like history? Tell me, is it a point that he did not like history? You know? So point is not that he did not like history. Point is that he wanted to explore history. Rather, he wanted to do more of history than what the teacher might have ever imagined. What it? So first point, make it clear that he was not poor in history. Second thing, it was not, okay, second question. Does it mean that Albert Einstein did not want to do history? It was also not so. He wanted to do history, rather he wanted to explore history. Okay, he wanted to go deeper into the aspects or norm or nuances of history. Third thing, was Albert Einstein a nuisance? Was he an indisciplined child? No. If a child is giving his point of view, that doesn't mean that he is an argumentative child or the child is indisciplined. Okay. He was just telling his viewpoint. It was not being indisciplined. Fourth question, was Albert Einstein creating fuss in the class? No. Again, the answer is same. He was simply putting forward his idea. And his idea was actually unique. Okay. So at the time, instead of, telling Albert Einstein that he was able to think in such a creative manner, the teacher called him a nuisance and told him to go out of the class. And even complained to the principal that this child is a nuisance and doesn't let him teach the class. So Albert Einstein, in the end, will be expelled from the school on the grounds of being indisciplined. Got it? Now the point is, whenever you are asked, was Albert Einstein weak in studies? Rather, he was a genius. Was he genius in history? Yes. He loved history. Was he nonsense or was he the one who argued with his teacher? No. He just expressed his point of view. There is a difference in expressing point of view and being argumentative. Argumentative is when you are wrong, even then you are arguing. It was not a matter of being wrong or right. It was simply a matter of giving opinion. And all children only have the right to speak up. The NEP 2020, it is all children-centered. It is all learner-centered. It is not at all teacher-centered. In this NEP 2020, it is all children who dominate the scene. Okay, the children, their viewpoint is important. Okay, nothing will be imposed. You people had been a little, you can say, now the next batches from 9th onwards, they won't have to opt from science or commerce or this. They can have any subject. They can have economics, chemistry, computers or anything, any combination they can have. Such a flexibility, such so much of flexibility is coming up. And that was there even in India before the times immemorial. That was actually our education system. Now the NEP 2020 is based upon Indian colors. It has got Indian colors. Beta, it is NEP 2020. It has already been implemented to some extent. Whatever is coming up, the school, all schools, not possible that we say like, we cannot, we will not. You know, the network is so strong. The IT sector of India has become so strong that each and every teacher's ID is there stored. You know, whatever the school, each school does, each teacher's activities they have there. So it's not that, and each student's data is there. So it's nothing is hidden now. It's not that we can do anything here in the classroom and they won't come to know. Everything is being, you know, recorded. Okay. I mean, the systems are very, very, you know, transparent now. So NEP 2020 is the biggest, you can say, contribution of the modern India to the children of today. Okay. We, if the things are done in very, very honest and sincere manner, then after 10 years, the face of India should be different. If the things are done in utmost, you know, honest manner. But because in the end, it is Indians only who always find out the way to manipulate the things. Okay? The policy has come up. It is the best ever educational policy. Best ever, I'm saying. Okay, it could not have been better or worse than this. It is best rather. No drawback is there. But it depends like how is it implemented. Okay, implementation is the biggest thing. Otherwise, laws are all there. There is a law against smoking. But has smoking been eradicated? But to some extent it has been. Now at least we don't find anyone smoking openly outside. Isn't it? When the laws are made, it takes some time to let them come into, you know, implementation. It takes some time, but eventually when they are implemented properly, their, you know, fruit is also realized. Right? So let's hope for the best. What Albert Einstein said then, that is finding its place in NEP 2020. That is there. Okay. So Albert Einstein, let's see. And yes, one thing more, what he loved apart from this, his maths was his favorite subject. His physics was his favorite subject. Maths was so favorite that the teacher of the school told him, like, I cannot teach you more than what I knew. Whatever I knew, I have taught you. Now you can go anywhere else and you can study maths. Right? And apart from this, Albert Einstein, the biggest quality of the creative genius or the scholarly people is, they don't do anything just for the heck of it. They don't just pass time. Albert Einstein, when he was, his last year was there in the school, 6 more months were left to complete his diploma, but he could not spend more 6 months in that situation. There were 2 reasons. One was he had already mastered maths, what was being taught in the school. He had already mastered physics, what was being taught in the school. Whatever the way history was being taught, that he did not like. It means that he knew that history also. So whatever was being taught in school, he knew that. The reality was that there was nothing in the school now which he had to learn yet. He had learned everything. But he did not know this. It was a maths teacher who told him, when he decided that he could not stay in the school any longer, because staying in the school would mean that carrying on the stress for no reason. And he didn't want to carry on the stress for no reason. He wanted to go out and study physics and maths. Imagine right now when you're in 11th standard and you feel that I've done all maths, physics, science, and how many children will have the guts to leave right now and try to pursue the next degree outside? Number one, it will be very difficult. It will be no child will be daring enough to leave the, because you will see, feel that's the reality also, like without my plus two certificate, I won't get any admission anywhere. How can I go? But he had these guts. He left the course in between and he went to the maths teacher and he told him, sir, like I want to leave. And the maths teacher gave him a reference. The maths teacher said, okay, yes, you are doing very right. Because there is nothing for you to learn in the school now. He says, like, whatever you, I had to teach you, I have taught. So he gave him a reference, like he was top class student in maths and was eligible to get admission in next stream. Got it? Despite the fact like he was so good in studies, despite the fact like he was one of the top class students of the school, he was not given the tag of being the best student. He was given the tag of being the most nuisance child of the school. He was termed as a nuisance child and he was expelled from the school. Got it? But you are to remember one thing, that Albert Einstein was very good in maths, physics, rather all subjects. He was not poor. He wanted to do everything. Some children in the end, you know what they say? He did not like history, so he did not want to study in that school. It's not so. He was not only in good terms with the history teacher. That was not his mistake. The mistake was of the teacher because the teacher could not understand his point of view. So he left the school. Rather, he also left the school from his side. And the school also asked him to leave the school. Both of the things happened together. Got it? So he left the school, or the school asked him to leave the school. And later on, what he did, the history knows. This was Albert Einstein at school. But whatever you read, you are to understand two things very carefully. Albert Einstein was very good in all subjects. He did not hate any subject. He was very good even in history. Number two, he was very, very disciplined. Okay. Maybe you're asked, like, was he a disciplined child? Yes, he was.
He was focused.
He was focused. He was disciplined. He was creative. He was original. Then why did he have a tussle with the history teacher? Because the teacher could not understand his point of view. Is that clear? So why did he leave the school? So that he could pursue his studies further. That's why he left the school. He did not leave school because he did not like to study. He left the school because he wanted to pursue higher education. Because he did not want to waste his time in the school. Because he had already done what was being taught in the school for the whole year. He had already done it in advance. So he left the school. Got it? So after he left the school, what he did, we all know. Okay. So Albert Einstein at school, it is about this. Okay. So tomorrow after the test, we might start off this story, the chapter. Today you can prepare your chapter, Ranga's marriage for test. Okay. So tomorrow will be a test in the class. Okay, children, online children, would that be fine? Pramod, yes. Pramod, yes. Those who are attentive, they can raise hand or they can show thumbs up. Okay, Arshdeep Singh, roll number 7, Gursirat, Harshvardhan, Yuvraj Singh, roll number 44, Amritpal. Amritpal, raise hand. Chirag Ahuja is also attentive. Okay. Yes. Okay, class over. Yeah, attendance register mein dal.